بسم الله، الحمد لله، والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. سبحانك لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا، اللهم علمنا ما ينفعنا وزدنا علما. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. My dear respected brothers and sisters, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept our fasting. And may Allah shower His rahmah and blessings upon all of us. And may Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala allow us to see and experience the fruits of our efforts in this world and also in the hereafter. Alhamdulillah, tonight by the grace of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, we have completed the 14th juz of the Holy Quran. In the 14th juz, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about many amazing things, of which Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala reminds us of the shortness of this life, and Allah warns us of the coming of the day of Qiyamah. Allah ta'ala says, وَمَا أَمْرُ السَّاعَةِ إِلَّا كَلَمْحِ الْبَصَرِ أَوْ هُوَ أَقْرَبُ. Allah says, regarding the matter of the hour, where the world will come to an end, Allah Ta'ala says the matter of the hour is like the blinking of an eye, or even closer than that. The Prophet of Allah on many occasions warned the Sahaba, لَوْ تَعْلَمُونَ مَا أَعْلَمُ. If you know what I know, لَضَحِكْتُمْ قَلِيلًا وَلَبَكَيْتُمْ كَثِيرًا. You would laugh a little and you would cry to another level. The Prophet of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam would constantly remind the Sahaba about the shortness of this life. The Prophet of Allah would constantly remind the Sahaba about the day of Qiyamah. The Quran is filled with reminders about the coming of the day of judgment. Allah takes many oaths in the Quran. La uqsimu bi yawmil qiyamah. Allah takes an oath by the day of Qiyamah. Allah says, وَالذَّارِيَاتِ ذَرْوَى فَالْحَامِلَاتِ وِقْرًا. Allah says, الْقَارِعَةُ مَالْقَارِعَةُ وَمَا أَدْرَاكَ مَالْقَارِعَةُ. Allah Ta'ala says, إِذَا وَقَعَتِ الْوَاقِعَةُ لَيْسَ لِوَقَعَتِهَا كَاذِبَةُ. Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala constantly in the Quran is reminding us about the day of Qiyamah. The Sahaba would twitch in their sleep when they would think about the day of judgment. The Prophet of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he says, Kayfa un'im, how can I be at ease? How can I be at ease when I know Angel Israfil has the trumpet by his lips and he is waiting for the command of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala? When Allah commands Israfil to blow the trumpet, this world will come to an end. فَإِذَا جَاءَتِ الصَّاخَّةِ. When the trumpet will be blown, the صَاخَّةِ, such a sigh which will cause the ears to become deaf instantly. This is the reality of our life. We need to remind ourselves. Imagine, the Prophet of Allah said, from the time Angel Israfil was created, he has not blinked his eye once. Imagine, he has not blinked his eye once. From the time he was created, he is looking at Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and he is waiting for the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to come so that he can blow the trumpet and this world will come to an end. My dear respected brothers, the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam made a dua. And what was his dua? Allahumma la aish illa aishul akhirah. Oh Allah, this world is not the true life. Oh Allah, the true life is akhirah. In another verse we recited tonight, Allah Ta'ala says, ma indakum yanfad wa ma indallahi baq. Allah Ta'ala says that whatever we have in this world will perish, but whatever we leave with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in akhirah, it is everlasting. What does this refer to? My dear respected brothers, this refers to what we have invested with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Do you know you're fasting, you're coming to the masjid, you're performing salatul taraweeh, all of these actions, this is currency for akhirah. This is building our akhirah. This is building our paradise. We need to understand these efforts, this time that you spend in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for this will grant us paradise. This is what we are here for. We are here to build our Jannah. We are here to build our Akhirah so that when the angel of death will come, we are smiling. We are prepared to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. My dear brothers, this is what we are leaving with Allah. All these good deeds that we are performing, our sadaqah, our salah, our fasting, our efforts, standing in salatul taraweeh, hoping for the reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We are sending all this ajr. It's like you go to work every single day. What do? You make an effort, you sweat, you take out your time so that you can, at the end, you want to receive an income, correct? So likewise, with our akhirah, every time you and I, we perform good deeds, we come for salah, we fast, we are building our bank balance with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We are investing with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We are taking a loan by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in another verse, وَمَا تُقَدِّمُوا لِأَنفُسِكُمْ مِنْ خَيْرٍ تَجِدُوهُ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ. Whatever you send forth of good, whatever good deeds, whatever form of good deeds, تَجِدُوهُ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ. You will find its reward by Allah, subhanAllah. هُوَ خَيْرًا وَأَعْظَمَ أَجْرًا. Allah is the greatest of those who grant reward. My dear brothers and sisters, do not feel for a moment that your good deeds are not being overlooked by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Every good deed that you perform, you will see it on the day of Qiyamah. فَأَمَّا مَنْ ثَقُلَتْ مَوَازِينُ فَهُوَ فِي عِيشَةٍ رَاضِيَةٍ. As for a person whose scale will be heavy with good deeds, on the day of Qiyamah, every atom of good, you will see it on the day of Qiyamah. Every atom of good, subhanAllah. Never underestimate any form of good deeds. My dear respected brothers, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, connecting to this verse, Allah then mentions the key to happiness. What is the key to happiness? Allah ta'ala says, مَنْ عَمِلَ صَالِحًا مِّن ذَكَرٍ أَوْ أُنْثَى وَهُوَ مُؤْمِنٌ. The person, the one who, a believer, a male or female, whoever performs righteous deeds, مَنْ عَمِلَ صَالِحًا, whoever performs أَعْمَالُ الصَّالِحًا, righteous deeds, وَهُوَ مُؤْمِنٌ, whilst he is a believer. So whoever does a'mal, whoever has believed in Allah, what will Allah grant us in return? Allah mentions in the surah which we've recited today. Allah says, فَلَنُحْيِيَنَّهُ حَيَاةً طَيِّبًا. Allah will grant you a life of happiness. Wallahi, my dear brothers and sisters, happiness and contentment can only be found in deen. Happiness and contentment, having a life of happiness, can only be found in being a mu'min, in having taqwa, in having a relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wallahi, every single human being, regardless of their faith, everyone is searching for happiness. True. Everyone wants to be happy. Allah is telling us in the Quran, مَنْ عَمِلَ صَالِحًا مِّن ذَكَرٍ أَوْ أُنْثَى وَهُوَ مُؤْمِنٍ فَلَنُحْدِيَنَّهُ حَيَاةً طَيِّبًا. Allahu Akbar. Listen to the words of Allah. Imagine. If we do good deeds, Allah is reminding us that if you are a believer, a male or a female, and you perform righteous deeds, Allah will grant you حَيَاةً طَيِّبًا. A very blessed life. A life full of barakah. A life full of happiness. A life full of contentment. Wallahi, one of the greatest bounties. Allah says also in the same verse, وَإِن تَعُدُّوا نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ لَا تُحْصُوهَا. That if we were to count the bounties of Allah, wallahi, we will never be able to do so. So my dear respected brothers and elders, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us firm iman. And may Allah allow us to reach the heights of the muttaqeen and the mu'mineen. Those people who are truly recognized by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Those people whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has granted a special status. May Allah make us of the mu'minun haqqa. The mu'minun haqqa. Who? Lahum darajatun inda rabbihim. Those who have a special status by Allah. Lahum darajatun inda rabbihim wa maghfira. And also these people, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has granted them forgiveness and barakah in their rizq. May Allah Azza wa Jal grant us the understanding to prepare for the coming of the hour. And may Allah Azza wa Jal grant us ikhlas. And may Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala accept all the good that we perform, insha'Allah Ta'ala. Subhanaka Allahumma wa bihamdika. Nashhadu an la ilaha illa anta nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk.